Subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon to never miss an update.
The first company you join is very, very critical, and therefore make the choice not just because of compensation or because of the designation that's been given to you, but because of the promise that this company provides to you in terms of the career they can offer.
Hello and welcome to another season of Conversations Cafe Online. Today, my guest is someone who has a long-standing career with one of the most important Indian conglomerates, Aditya Birla Group. And I am Calcutta grad. Shruti joined Aditya Birla Group from campus and has worked in multiple roles, taking responsibilities in different sectors of the textile business of the group. Currently, the GM head of marketing and e-commerce of Jayashree Textiles, Shruti will take us through her journey within the group and what motivates her to carry on with the group. Thanks, Shruti, for joining us and welcome to Conversations Cafe Online.
Thanks, Pranshu. Happy to be here.
All right. Shruti, take us a little back to your B-school days. What was it like, being part of IIM Calcutta, and how did the learning take shape for you from there to now when you're working with AIIMS?
I think I have some very, very fond memories of campus, Joka, as we fondly used to call it. Of course, the session is rigorous, 2 years of hardcore learning. But I think the biggest takeaway for me is really the connections and the friendships that I built on campus, which I still cherish, and friendships that have stayed on for 11 years out of campus.
Right. And along with the learning, your first opportunity also came your way through the summer internship at IIM Calcutta. You took part as a summer intern with Idea Cellular, the telecom company of ABG. What do you think happened when you received a PPO next from there?
So my internship at that time with Idea Cellular was a very, very interesting stint. We were looking to expand our presence in rural India. So my project was around increasing penetration for Idea in the rural sector. And I remember the first day I went to meet my boss, he said, Shruti, your project is rural India, so you shouldn't be in Mumbai. You have to travel across rural India and come back and meet me after a month. In the 8 weeks of internship that I had, I traveled for 4 weeks. I traveled rural India across 6 states. And as someone who loves traveling, of course, I loved the travel that I had. But more important was the consumer emotion that I had over those 4 to 6 weeks. And luckily, when I came back and presented, the work was appreciated and I got a PPO.
How was your experience being part of the ABJLP program for the first year when you were inducted? How was the segmentation of profiles like? Did you get a diverse pool of things to work on?
ABG talks about itself as a world of opportunities, and the leadership program is one of the flagship programs the group runs. And it follows the same ethos that the group has in terms of believing that its leaders should have exposure across multiple sectors, multiple functions, and multiple geographies. And the leadership program is custom designed to ensure that participants, of course, subject to performance, but participants who are doing well get the kind of exposure that will take them to leadership roles in an accelerated way. So in my case, for example, when I started off in year one itself, I had exposure through 4 stints. So at that time, the leadership program in year one used to do 4 stints, 3 months each. Now it is 3 stints, 4 months each. And over those 4 months, I got exposed to telecom, textiles, financial services, and cement. And I worked in Bangalore, Mumbai, and Thailand. And I worked across marketing, risk management, innovation, and supply chain. So
played quite full, I would say.
Really, in 1 year, I had 4 into 4 into 3 exposure, which was amazing.
I think from this stint of yours, you decided that you wanted to be in retail operations, and you then become a area manager. What were some fascinating things that you remember from this particular stint?
The biggest challenge was that I was a fresher. This really was my first role, and I was given a team of 25 store managers to lead. And typically, a store manager would bring in at least 10 to 15 years of experience. So here I was all of 22, 23 years old, and I had a team of some 25 really experienced store managers and an overall team of 100 people to lead. And I think retail operations is all about people management and being able to inspire your team to do well. So the biggest challenge and the biggest learning for me in this stint was about how to get this team to sort of respect me and work with me and deliver on the targets.
Right. You know, you handled operations, you became the operations manager there, and then you handled strategy and new initiatives with the Aditya Birla Textiles. Take us through, you know, how all these roles shaped you up to a position that you are in right now that we are going to talk about next.
Yeah, so from doing retail operations, which was really looking at one territory, so I looked at Karnataka and Mumbai, and I was responsible for on-ground operations. I got an absolutely different exposure a couple of years later when I joined the business head's office as head of strategy. And in ABFRL, really, I was working at the consumer end. So we were looking at retail, which is the last leg of interaction in the textile value.
Right.
Where one works directly with consumers. And then I moved to the textile value chain, which is the manufacturing side of the business. And I found both to be equally exciting. So I never thought that manufacturing business itself would give me so much learning and challenge. And the role that I had again was something that I think the group again took a risk on me with. So 2 years experience, they gave me a role in the business head's office. And my stakeholders changed from store managers to CEOs and senior leaders of the company.
You next became the India Linen Club GM head of marketing. You delved into the big bad world of marketing, dealing with brands, advertisements and whatnot at this point in time. What were some of the initiatives that your team took at this point in time when you were working with this Linen Club team? And it was also the time, you know, when digital was on the rise. You were also seeing changes every day when you were going to office and, you know, meeting your colleagues and teams and seeing things happening around you. How did you look into this as a challenge or an opportunity?
So when I took over as head of marketing for Linen Club, Linen Club was already an established brand in the market. But it was more a trade brand. And as a consumer, it was not really spoken about. It was not really marketed to the consumer. So from a strategy perspective, the company wanted to build Linen Club at the consumer end. And when I came on board, I think I got a clean slate. I was lucky. We had a new CEO who came in, who brought in a lot of B2C experience. And I worked very, very closely with him through my marketing stint. And I saw exposure across the gamut of marketing. So right from hiring the team to hiring a creative agency and the media agency to getting into consumer immersion again and a lot of consumer researches to understand the category, to understand what consumers are talking about and just understanding how researches work in my case. To then getting into brand positioning and where this brand could actually sit. To finally working with the creative agency into getting some ads out. And we had Farhan Akhtar who came over as brand ambassador. So working with the celebrity and seeing how that works and how that sort of
plays. Was it very intimidating or interesting, Shruti, at that point in time?
It was interesting. I was lucky that Farhan isn't too intimidating. So it was obviously interesting and exciting to work with celebrity. And like you rightly said, you know, marketing is going through this very, very interesting phase where digital is coming in a way that one would not have really anticipated. And today, one cannot do marketing plans where one says that, okay, digital is a part of my plan. No digital plans. So looking at the entire digital marketing evolve, like in 2010, when I graduated from IIM Calcutta, we didn't have a course on digital marketing. I don't think that is possible today. I mean, a curriculum in marketing without digital is an absolutely impossible thing today.
Right. You know, next, what happened to Shruti was Jayashree Textiles. Given the times that we are living in, how do you think e-commerce has grown and how effective do you think it has become in the scheme of things for your business at the moment?
So from Linen Club as head of marketing, we were seeing digital shaping up and e-commerce seemed to be like a natural progression for me. So I took over as head of marketing for a slightly larger part of the business and started looking at other segments of the business. And interestingly, got e-commerce into my profile. Luckily, last year when COVID came in, I found myself the opportunity of being part of this space. I have to look at what one can do every day because there are events that are coming in. Platforms always have something or the other that's happening. There again, new formats are getting tried. Platforms are competing with each other. One has the chance of setting up one's own direct-to-consumer platform. So there's just so much play in terms of what e-commerce can offer. And for a business like ours, which was traditionally manufacturing, to make the move towards being a consumer-oriented business, to getting into services and then getting into e-commerce, I think that transition's been such an interesting one and an exciting one because it's also a change in mindset that one is bringing along, not just for the consumers and how they see us, but also for ourselves and how I see ourselves.
Absolutely. Any last messages to, you know, aspirants or students who are watching this at this moment, not very sure about their career goals or aspirations?
I think I had got advice. So when I did my first stint with Idea Cellular, my boss at that time had given me very good advice. And he'd said that, you know, in the initial years of your career, it is very important that you work with a big company and you work with a company that really values your career. The first company you join is very, very critical and therefore make the choice not just because of compensation or because of the designation that's been given to you, but because of the promise that this company provides to you in terms of the career they can offer. And I think that's where ABG sits beautifully.
Absolutely. Thank you very much, Shruti, for you know, sharing your journey with us, sharing these insights with us. That was really helpful for all the people out there. And to all of the viewers who are watching this, if you have any questions that you want to direct to Shruti, you can do that by registering yourself for the Conversations Cafe Online Season 2. Thanks once again, Shruti, for being part of this conversation. I really enjoyed this conversation and all the very best for your future endeavors.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you so much.